Good afternoon, dear students. Hope you all good. Sit it. So frequently wash your hands. After every class, you go and wash your hands. So you can protect yourself from COVID-19. Okay. Now, let us come to the lesson. Which lesson we have started, students, and which village we have visited? Yes, very good. We all have visited Penamakuru village, which is on the Krishna Delta. A village on the delta. So, in the previous class, we discussed about the vegetables which they'll grow in the Penamakuru village. And during the summer, what the farmers will grow? Jilugar, Pillipesara, I said to fix the nitrogen in the soil. Isn't it, students? Now, our next topic is today, orchards. Orchards means what, students? Yes, good. Where the fruit grows. That is called orchards. Very good. So, on the bank of River Krishna. Where? On the bank of River Krishna. So, on the bank of River Krishna and uplands of Penamakuru and upland areas of Penamakuru. Uplands, which areas are uplands? In the previous class we have discussed northern and the western part of Penamakuru is uplands. So they cannot irrigate with the canal water here. Irrigation means what? Giving water to the crop. So they cannot give water to the northern and western part of Penamakuru village because the canal is passing through the southern and eastern part of the village. So on the uplands, on the bank of the river Krishna and on uplands areas of Penamakuru, we can see here fruit bearing trees. That means what? Here on the uplands and on the bank of the river Krishna, they'll grow fruits. So here fruit bearing trees are available. And on the bank of river Krishna and on the uplands, what kind of soil available? You know, students, here the sandy soil is available. What kind of soil is available? Sandy soil is available. So, sandy soil, what is the feature of sandy soil? It will not hold water for a long time. Here, sandy soil is available. So, this sandy soil, what is the feature of the sandy soil? It will not hold water for a long time, like alluvial soil and clay black soil. Alluvial black soil and clay black soil, what happens? It will store, it will hold water for a long time. That means wetness will be there for a long time. But sandy soil will not percolate water and it will not hold water for a long time. So, in these areas, they will grow the fruit bearing trees. Maybe you are thinking, see teacher, when it will not hold water, sandy soil, how the fruits will grow, isn't it? But for the fruit trees, the roots will be very deep. Fruit trees, the roots will be very, very deep. So, it will automatically from under the ground, it will take out water and it will absorb. Okay, students. So, that's why on the bank of river Krishna and on uplands, they will grow fruits here in Penamakuru village. Okay. So, here what kind of soil is available? Sandy soil. Okay. And sandy soil will not hold water for a long time. Okay. And how the fruit trees will get water? That is the question I asked. Even you asked me, I think so. So, but the roots of these trees will be very, very deep inside the soil. So, automatically it will take water from the soil. Okay, students? And hence, the lands close to the river suitable for growing the fruit-bearing trees. Okay, students, understood now about orchards. Orchards means what? Where the fruit grows. That is called orchards. So, in the Penamakuru, on the bank of river Krishna and uplands, fruit bearing trees are available. And what kind of fruits they'll grow here, you know, students? Guava, sapota is also called in English chiku. Okay, students, and papaya. What fruits they'll grow in Penamakuru on the bank of river Krishna and uplands? They'll grow guava. Guava means, you know, yes, guava, sapota is also called chiku. Okay, students, and papaya. These three kinds of fruits will grow on the bank of river Krishna and uplands. Okay, students. Next, our topic is irrigation, market and changing crops. Irrigation, market and changing crops. Okay, our next topic is irrigation. Market and changing crops. Let us see what is given under this topic. Okay. So, irrigation means what? Already I said you giving water to the agriculture fields are called irrigation. Okay. Even we have seen that there is a shifting up. Yes, in the previous lesson when we discussed about the crops, I told you that now farmers present in Penmakuru, they instead of growing paddy, they are growing sugarcane, turmeric, yam and banana, I said. Do you remember, students? Previous what they have grown paddy, second crop paddy or pulse, I said. Then what I said, presently the farmers are growing sugarcane because it will stand on the soil for nearly 9 to 12 months. And it will be ready for the second crop also after that. That's why they are growing, I said, isn't it? So along with sugarcane, on the uplands, what they will grow? Vegetables. And they'll grow banana. Okay, yam. Okay. So, why the farmers of Perumbakkam, you know this question every year he'll ask, I'm observing. Why the farmers of Perumbakkam or why the farmer shifted from food grains to the what? Cash crops. Food crops to the cash crops. This question always he'll ask. Okay, let us see. Why the farmers here, they shifted. Shifted means instead of growing food grains, why they started growing the cash crops. Food crops means paddy, pulses, these all food crops. And only for selling, if they grow cash crops like turmeric, banana, I said, they'll not use for themselves. So, turmeric, banana, all they will sell in the market. So, these are the cash crops. So, why the farmer shifted in Penmakkam from food crops to cash crops. Why they shifted from food crops or food grains to cash crops? Why they have shifted from food crops to the cash crops? Why they have shifted? Because they having availability of loans. So these farmers, they are having the availability of loans. And you know one thing, for the food crops, than food crops or cash crops, they need more water. They need more water. So what made them to grow cash crops instead of food crops? Because of irrigation. See, even for cash crops, they need more water. But even though they have grown, why? Because they have the availability of loans. Availability of loans. So banks are giving them loans. Loans means what? Money the banks will give them on interest. So, because they are getting the loans to purchase. Why the farmers, they need loans? Actually, why they want money? They want money to buy the seeds. Good quality of seeds they know need to grow crops. And they need water. And they need fertilizers. Fertilizers means the medicine for the plants. Okay, so the availability of loans to purchase seeds and fertilizers. Seeds and fertilizers. Already water is available in the Penmakkam village. As we discussed, they will get water from 15 to 25 feet only. So, all the farmers they are going for bore wells. Isn't it? So, now water is available because water is, they are getting from 15 to 25 feet and it's not costly to dig the bore wells here in Penmakkam. So, water is available. Now, question, they need money. Isn't it? That money the banks are giving to the farmers loans. So, they are to buy the seeds and fertilizers. Every year, they'll buy the seeds from the government, good quality of seeds. If the good quality of seeds are sown, they'll get the good yield. Good yield means more crops. So, they are having availability of loans to buy seeds and fertilizers. Okay. And even they are having the irrigation. So, this is the reason why the farmers are growing cash crops. They shifted from food crops to, I'll write here, shifted from food crops to cash crops. Okay, students. So we'll ask every time question why the farmer shifted from food crops to cash crops. Why? Because of the availability of loans to purchase seeds and fertilizers. Even irrigation facility is also available in Penamakuru. That's why the farmer shifted from food crops to the cash crops. Now here one question for you students. If all the farmers, if they grow cash crops, what happens? Tell me. Instead of growing fruit crops means paddy pulses. So if instead of growing this, if they started growing only cash crops, all the farmers, then what happens to us? Yes, exactly what happens? We will get the scarcity of food crops. Scarcity means the food crops will not be available in the market. See, cash crops is sugar cane, turmeric, banana. By eating that, we cannot survive, isn't it? We need food grains. So there will be scarcity of food grains if the farmers grows only cash crops. I think so you all have understood. One question I asked you, why the farmer shifted from food crops to cash crops? Answer, even I said, because they are having the availability of irrigation and they are having the availability of loans to purchase. See, this seeds and fertilizers are called inputs, students. What it is called? Inputs. So they are having the availability of loans to purchase inputs like seeds and fertilizers. For this reason, they are shifted from food crops to the cash crops. Next question, what I asked, if all the farmers grows only cash crops, what happens? If all the farmers grows only cash crops, then there will be scarcity of food crops. Scarcity means the food crops won't be available. Scarcity means not available. So if only cash crops all will grow farmers, then we won't get food crops to eat, isn't it? So these are the two questions every year in the question paper they will repeat. If all the farmers grow cash crops, what happens? They'll ask. What happens if all the farmers grow cash crops? This is one question they'll ask. And next, why the farmer shifted from food crops to the cash crops? And two questions I said and even answers I said, I will send you as homework also. Okay, for learning, start question and answers. Okay, and even today or tomorrow, I'll see that I will send second lesson question and answers. Okay, students, thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. Good afternoon, dear students. Hope you all good. Isn't it? So frequently wash your hands. After every class, you go and wash your hands so you can protect yourself from COVID-19. Okay, now let us come to the lesson. Which lesson we have started, students, and which village we have visited? Yes, very good. We all have visited Penamakuru village, which is on the Krishna Delta. A village on the Delta. So, in the previous class, we discussed about the vegetables which they'll grow in the Penamakuru village, and during the summer what the farmers will grow, jiluga or pili pesara, I said, to fix the nitrogen in the soil, isn't it, students? Now our next topic is today orchards. Orchards means what, students? Yes, good. Where the fruit grows, that is called orchards. Very good. So on the bank of river Krishna, where? On the bank of river Krishna. So, on the bank of river Krishna and uplands of Penamakuru and upland areas of Penamakuru. Uplands, which areas are uplands? In the previous class we have discussed, northern and the western part of Penamakuru is uplands. So, they cannot irrigate with the canal water here. Irrigation means what? Giving water to the crop. So, they cannot give water to the northern and western part of Penamakuru village because the canal is passing through the southern and eastern part of the village. So, on the uplands, on the bank of the river Krishna and on uplands, areas of Penamakuru, we can see here fruit bearing trees. That means what? Here on the uplands and on the bank of the river Krishna, they'll grow fruits. So, here fruit bearing trees are available. And on the bank of river Krishna and on the uplands, what kind of soil available? You know, students, here the sandy soil is available. What kind of soil is available? Sandy soil is available. So sandy soil, what is the feature of sandy soil? It will not hold water for a long time. This is the well. Okay, students. Then, so what happens if well water they will use to grow the crops even during the drought year? Okay, when no rainfall is there, that is called drought, I said. So even these tanks will help. What I said first, tanks not only give water to the human beings, even it give water to the animals, and even it will be useful to grow some crops in agriculture field for irrigation. They can use the tank water, isn't it? And even during the time of drought, they can use that land for growing crop. These are all the. How did the tanks help? That answer you have to write if in the exam they give. How did the tanks help? Means tanks will give not only water to the human beings, animals, and even the tank water will be useful for irrigating the crops. And during the drought, this land can be used for growing at least some crops. Okay. And even this tanks helps us to increase the water level. Increase the water level. To increase the water level in the wells nearby. What is the meaning of this, students? Water level in the wells nearby. Meaning what? I'll tell you what is the meaning. So if in the tanks the water is fully filled, what happens? You know, surrounding areas. See, agriculture fields are there beside it, and surrounding in the villages also. If wells are there, because of this tank water, most of the water will be percolated by the soil. Okay, so because of this, what happened? Nearby wells, the water level also increases. The water will be available in the wells. Okay, see, we will observe the well water also in the summer season, it will decrease. And even in the bore wells, we will observe that during the summer season, some of the bore wells will get dry. And water will, we cannot use the water of the bore well. Sometimes some people, they'll buy water from outside by the tankers, isn't it? So, if tanks are there, it will help to increase the water level in the wells nearby and even in the bore wells nearby. Okay. In this way, the tanks helpful to us. And even after the rain stopped and the tank water decreased, the tank bed could be used for raising some crops. Already I said. So, okay, students. So, how did the tanks help? Tanks will give water to the human beings, animals, and even to irrigate the agriculture fields. And during the drought, we can raise some crops. Drought means what I said? No rainfall. If any particular year, in the rainy season, if no rainfall, that year is called drought year. Okay, students. And even this tanks will helpful to increase the water level in the wells nearby. Okay, students. Now, I would like to ask few questions. Then, I will end this session. Okay, and even these answers, I will send you through. Never skip. Okay, few questions let me ask. How are the tanks help? Or how did the tanks help? Okay, next question. How were the tanks built? I explained, you know, how the tanks built. They will build a strong wall across the stream. So these answers I will post. So you learn these two questions. Okay, students. So you read the lesson and learn the slot question answers. And I will try to send the second lesson notes also, students. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.